We've been hearing the warnings about the drug ice for years now, how it captures you quickly and can consume you entirely. However, more people are listing the methamphetamine as their primary addiction. But what is also on the rise is the number of people who are seeking help. We're joined now by the Salvation Army's Major Bruce Harmer, as well as former addict Nick Nash. Welcome to you both.
Thank you.
Nick, we've got to start with you. You were hooked very early on. What is it about? Because we keep hearing how destructive ice is and how it hooks you very quickly. Yeah. What was it about ice that grabbed you?
I don't know, really. I started with other drugs and then slowly, as the years went on, I turned to ice. And I don't know, as soon as I used it, I just didn't stop, really.
You're still a really young man. You only just turned 20. When did you start? When did you start with, say, other drugs to start with, and then how did that sort of...
Other drugs, I started when I was just about nearly 17, so year 11 at school, and I dropped out of school when I started using other drugs. But I used other drugs for about 2 years, and I was just using whatever I could get my hands on, really, except I always hated ice because of all the bad attention it gets from everybody, so I always told myself I'd steer clear of that. But I don't know, when I was about probably just turned 18, I just thought, oh, you know, I might as well give it a go. Everyone's using it.
And have a friend offer it to you?
Yeah.
Can you explain what it feels like? It's just got such a stigma from the outside, but what does it actually feel like?
I don't know, it kind of gives you a euphoric kind of feeling, but it just gives you energy, gives you confidence, and so I can see why it appeals to people, but I don't know, it just seems to snatch everyone up real quick.
And Nick, what was it? We were talking before off air about how for you, your brother had problems with drugs, and then you also thought you wanted to get out of what was going on in your mind, so that's why you sort of turned to them, wasn't it?
Yeah, definitely, because I don't know, I never realised it from a young age, and in fact I never really realised it until probably 6 months ago, but I can never get out of my own head. I give myself a really hard time in my head, so I'm really critical of myself.
You're saying it gives you confidence, it gave you confidence and gave you energy. Do you feel like at that point in your life that's what you were lacking and that's what you were trying to find?
Yeah, I think so, and just something different and a way to escape 24 hours a day, because it's one of the only drugs you can just use and use and use and not sleep. And so
what happens, and believe me, I've been there, what happens when you, you know, you're 18 years old, your friend passes something, you're smoking it, or you're...
Yeah, smoking it.
And how does it then go? You think, well, I'll just try it once. How does that then go to you being a regular user and getting out of control?
You don't even realise it. It's just... Before you even know it, it's been 6 months and you've used it every chance you get. You're always just looking for it. You're never doing anything else.
You want every day?
Yeah.
What was the moment when you thought, okay, this has got to stop? I've reached the point of no return. If I don't stop now, I'll die.
I never really had that moment consciously. I think maybe subconsciously I knew it, but I was just completely pushing that away, just ignoring the fact that that could be a possibility. And when I booked into rehab, it was kind of just to kind of make everyone happy and make it look like I was doing something, and I was getting in trouble with the courts and stuff, so I was kind of to get myself out of hot water. And I wasn't actually going to go on the day, but for some reason that morning I woke up and I decided to get in the car and go, and it was the best thing I've ever done. And it probably took a month of being in rehab to realise, hang on, maybe I actually do need a change.
What was it that made you, during that month, think, I've got to change my life?
A lot of it was to do with how nice the people were and just how good the salvos are and how good the program is. And I could see it changing other people and how happy they were. So I thought, maybe this is for me, because I was like, it was a bed, because I was living on the street for a while beforehand. And then, it was just a bed. It was so good.
Bruce, as manager of the Salvo's Drug and Rehab Centre here in Sydney as well, do you see ice as exponentially a problem as it appears from the outside?
Oh, absolutely. We've seen a 41% increase, which is just slightly higher than our national increase for the Salvation Army. 41% increase over the last 5 years, which has made a huge difference to the way that we do our treatment as well. Mm-hmm. We've had to adjust. We've had to include mental health issues much earlier on in the program. We almost do them concurrently now. And deal with the two at the same time. So it's made a huge difference.
And we hear a lot about, the thing with rehab, firstly, you've got to get the number of beds and you've got to have a bed available. You were talking, Nick, about, just that moment where it's 50-50 whether you go to rehab or not. If you rock up there and say, well, okay, yes, I will, and someone says, oh, actually, there's not a bed till next Tuesday, that's that window shut, isn't it? So there's got to be a bed available as soon as an addict makes that call.
Absolutely, and that's true. And look, we're all making as many beds available as we can. We have about a 2 or 3 week waiting list.
Yeah.
But if Nick was to walk in and happen to come across me, I think we'd find a bed. We'd make room, and we do that as much as we can because these are people. Yeah. They're not just statistics. Yeah. Yeah. They're someone's son. They're someone's partner. They're someone's father, possibly, and they need as much support as we can provide them.
Bruce, I admire you, what you do, and because I've been involved in the cross for over 40 years, and I did a lot of work with the Wayside Chapel, and I saw this hideous drug, and I think, what's your future now? You know, I'm so proud of you because I've seen it face to face.
Thank you.
And I get a little bit teary because I know how hard these people work. Yeah. So what's your future?
At the moment, I'm studying at TAFE and I plan to maybe, which is something I never would have done before. I hated school and I dropped out of school in year 11. But I'm planning on maybe going to uni next year as a mature age student.
Wow.
And I want to do social work or something like that, psychology, just anything. I want to work with youth as well while I'm young.
Yay.
How good are the Salvos? If you or anyone you know is battling with addiction, the Salvos are always there to help. You can head to thesalvos.org.au or call 13SALVOS, which is 137258. Major Bruce Harmer and Nick Nash, thank you so much.
Thank you.